Good morning, dear friends. Today is 11th July 2017 and I was just thinking about myself, my life, and then just wanted to introspect. Rather would like to share my views on how my life had passed. What were my successes? What were my failures? What did I get? What I did not get? How I was when I was a child? And how the children of nowadays are there? So I'm trying to compare with the children of this time. As far as I can go back to my childhood, I remember at the age of 12 to 13, 14 years, when I was in 7th, 8th, 9th class in Government Higher Secondary School, Dharamsala, Himachal Pradesh. I remember that I was very, very introvert, I was shy, very shy of meeting people, talking freely to my teachers, talking freely to my relatives, talking freely to friends of my dad. In fact, I avoided them because I remember that in my time we used to think my thought process had been like that, that respect at that age, let me say it was nearly 60s, 70s, respect means not coming in front of a person, putting your head down and just crossing the person, even not wishing. So I used to have that idea that the respect means that you should not interact with your seniors, particularly these people about whom I talk, and that was in my character. I remember when in the school I was standing at 30th or 40th position in the morning assembly. It was Government Higher Secondary School, Dharamsala, Himachal Pradesh. When I was in 8th or 9th class, in the morning assembly, our instructors and teachers who were conducting, they pointed their finger at me and tried to call me in front of the assembly. The moment I looked at their finger, I tilted my head in such a way that all of they got covered behind the head of my friend standing in front of me. They tilted their position in such a way that again we had an eye-to-eye contact. Again I tilted my head. Then suddenly when this went for a few seconds, it was a state of confusion for me why I have been called. And they also, since they were the masters, they thought that they should take me in front of all the entire assembly. And they took me in the assembly. And they told me to speak something. When they told me to speak something, suddenly something happened, and I started crying. It was not a crying with the loud voice. It was my gestures were so not appropriate to that moment. Then they said, okay, please come prepared next time. So I remember, and I thank God that, thank you very much, God, you saved me. I went back. This is one of my incidents in my life which I have never forgotten. That entire picture, I can visualize that moment. This is one reason. Now, if I compare this with the children of this time, I find them, they are ready to be called on the stage for a question, because I've been a principal. When I ask them, how many of you can come and interact with me in the morning assembly, director, director, I had seen in my all school, in Kendra Vidyalaya and in all other school, I had seen that I got a huge, tremendous response from the children. Sir, please call me or I will interact with you direct in the assembly. That is the confidence of the children of this generation. And hats off to the parents and the teachers for bringing up this generation with this much of confidence. I really salute the parents who are worried about their children, because they feel that there is a time of competition. Unless the parents directly involve themselves with the growth of the child, with the progress of the child might remain behind somewhere. In our time, it was not there. In our time, our parents were not, they were as intellectual as the parents of this time, but they were, their style was totally different. They wanted us to grow, and they just wanted to, and they, in fact, they kept some information about us, about studies only. How he is going on studies, if, since I was very good in studies, so my father was very proud to talk to all his friends that he is my, Hare Krishna is my son, and he's a topper here and there in this class and in this subject. But I used to avoid to talk to the friends of my dad because I was extremely introverted. In fact, I used to hide behind my dad and avoided eye-to-eye contact with the friends of my dad. But nowadays it's not like that. Children of this age, they are very, very happy to come in front of their relatives, their elders, their teachers, and interact them. That is the confidence and that is a change which I have seen over these 40, 50 years of my lifespan. In my time, I feel perhaps we were not taught directly. We were encouraged, but not very much encouraged to interact with the people, because in my time, we felt that giving respect to elders means avoiding them, not coming in front of them. I remember an incident when I was principal. It was 1994, and I had gone to Dharamsala to my parents. I got two of my friends, one is Indra Mohan and another is Vijay Jakaria. All of us were strolling, and when we were moving on the road, I saw my principal of my time, Dr. Tarachandji, whom we revered a lot, coming in front with his stick and his cap, walking down, and we were walking up the road because it is a hill station. And then the moment we saw, I told both of them, my friends, let's avoid him here, let's get off the track and move on the other side of the road. Then they told me, why you are doing it? You are yourself a principal. Oh, I said, I'm very sorry. I had that instinct in me that, and I was recalled of my old timing when we used to avoid our principals. We used to avoid our teachers. All we used to avoid our seniors, because we had a notion that avoiding means giving respect. And now I have learned it's not like that. Perhaps my this behavior was not noticed by my parents. I might have been corrected at that time, but nowadays I find my parents and with the parents of the children whom I have taught extremely active, very much vigilant, very alert, and they are very observant. They see the behavior of the child and they want the children to be at the top. They don't want their child to lose a competition anywhere at any time. So such are the times which have changed. Maybe because of the a lot of explosion of knowledge is there. A lot of technology is there, and the children are now very much technology savvy. And maybe one of this reason is, But the other reason is that when the parents, if they notice the child, because the thought process has changed over 30 to 40 years, how children should behave, how the children should look disciplined. And the definition of all these things, right from discipline to the behavior, etiquettes have totally changed. This is what I experienced. So my request to parents is that you may disagree with me, you may not disagree with me, but then kindly have a total look what your child wants, what is his needs, how does he behave, and how does your child is required to be reformed. He has to be encouraged, he has to be taught, all these things. The parents have to be extremely vigilant about the child. In our time it was not so. So thank you very much. I'll be sharing such more experiences with you because I love to speak my experiences, and I'm going to put this as a private video. I'll test it and put it for the public on YouTube. If it gets a good response, I'll continue making such more videos and sharing with you my experiences of the life, because I got a lot of time to share with you. Thank you very much, and namaskar. God bless all of you.